Indeed, we all breathe, feel, and dance. I feel that dance is a movement that we do. It's not just a technical form. It doesn't exist in the studios only. The movement we do down the streets, the pushing of the strollers, anything that is movement-based, gesture-based, can inform dance. It can inform creation, and I love that. And that in dancing, everyone should have a meaningful experience. My piece is called Trace de Pas, which is looking at traces and footsteps. I'm looking at the idea of the ways in which we arrive in space to do the work that we do as dancers. What are the ancestries and the things that we carry into those particular space? And how do we honor them and invite audiences into the body, the person moving, rather than the technique moving? I'm really using a natural perspective in terms of how we move innately in our bodies, the archetype of their bodies, the poses that exist in their bodies. And I'm augmenting those particular relationships through technique, through contemporary dance, along with the structure of the music to amplify what will become Trace de Pas. It starts out in a duet structure. I have to break expectations about seeing those dancers connecting with each other, contacting each other, because it's also been filmed and was created in a time of COVID. And so I have to think about how to amplify those two bodies in space, and then how a third body will be introduced to the work to break that relationship. Just really thinking about what exactly are the states. See, states, I talk about states of being. There's a responsive space, a contemplative space, an observing space. So all these concepts also of how do we respond to history? How do we contemplate our own impact on the world? How do we observe others in space is very much a part of this work as well. We start by exploring material rather than going in and saying, I have this material, learn this, and then you replicate it. We go in with that material and then we amplify it in space. So I might say, take half the phrase and you do it on this particular path. Or take the other half and do it over here. At the end of the day, because it's a choreography, it becomes the piece. But you're always innately having that conversation with music. So maybe you arrive at a particular space in place early, but you know what you've been doing, you know the music intimately, so you can amplify that moment. And that moment for me is quite okay. So how do you transform an experience of a theater into an experience that is now online or seen through recording? And I think there's many things there also about using the online platform and a recorded video platform as an introduction to something, as an experience. How do you create that experience? For me, the intimacy of that experience amplifies the intent. I'm curious about having the audience who will be online, so they're a part of the choreography, they're a part of the movement structure, because in a time like this, I think it's about also how audiences, viewers, are finding meaning with dance and finding meaning with the dancers and the skill and the athleticism it takes to actually execute movement in dance. The power of dance for healing inward the things that we have and are questioning becomes something that is not about outward. It becomes an inward expression. And the more we can actually think of dance as an inward expression that we're sharing to someone, is the more we're actually healing ourselves and then offering that healing to somebody else. There's many things that exist in the world and society around us that dance offers as a solution and a possibility at the same time.